Okay, and after this, please allow me to share my screen. I hope you all have filled your examination form.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I think day before yesterday only I have shared a list those who have not filled the examination form. So please pass this message to your friends, and you know, accordingly you do it. So wherever we guys have stopped yesterday, from that particular point onwards, we are starting with your lecture. As I told you yesterday only, we are taking lectures till Saturday. Saturday only I will stop taking lectures, and on that day only I'll be declaring that syllabus is over. Before that, we will have a lecture per day at 11:30 sharp. There is one more request to you all. Have you received something from accounts teacher?
No, sir.
Okay. I'll get back to him today and let you know. Okay, so do you remember where we guys have stopped yesterday? काल कुठे थांबलो होतो आठवते का?
अपॉइंटमेंट ऑफ टास्क एंड सेटलमेंट ऑफ फंड.
हाँ.
नंबर 17.
पेज नंबर?
चैप्टर नंबर 17, पेज नंबर 32.
Okay, good, thank you. Very nice for your answers. Page number 32. There we guys have stopped. Page number 31 we have seen, page number 32, and we were talking about this two, zero rated supply, section 16 we have seen thoroughly, and we were discussing about section number 17. In section number 17, we are going to talk about apportionment of tax and settlement of funds. So yesterday only I have told you the concept of apportionment and the concept of settlement of fund, which is given according to section 17 of IGST Act 2017. So in this particular section, we are going to highlight, we are going to focus on two different aspects, and those two different aspects are apportionment of tax and settlement of funds. So there are provisions regarding that. I'm going to read the provisions one by one, and accordingly I will explain all those provisions in this particular lecture. Look at the provision number one. What is the provision number one? Says that out of the integrated tax paid to central government. So there is a provision in this particular section 17, and this provision relates to the tax which is collected through goods and IGST, or which is collected through integrated tax, and this tax which is paid to central government. In that regard, this particular provision is made. So in respect of interstate supply of goods or services, or both, to an unregistered person or to a registered person paying tax under section 10 of the Central Goods and Services Tax Act, in respect of interstate supply of goods or services, or both, where the registered person is not eligible for input tax credit. So here they have been talked about the tax which we collect under section 10 of CGST Act, and we collect this particular tax as a part of interstate supply. So they have been talked about interstate supply goods and services, as well as they have been talked about the tax which is collected under section 10 of CGST Act 2017. And here they are talking about the person who is eligible or who is not eligible for input tax credit. So this one is the thing that they have discussed in first paragraph. In respect of interest rate supply of goods or services or both made in financial year to a registered person where he does not avail of input tax credit within the specified period and thus remains in the integrated tax account after expiry of the due date for furnishing of annual return for such year in which supply was made. So here they have talked about the interstate supply of goods and services which are made during a financial year by a registered person. So see, when we go for any sort of accounting, like accounting of that we normally do in our regular practice, even we go for accounting of taxation, GST accounting is also there. So whatever taxes we pay in a during that particular financial year, those that particular taxes or those amounts are considered here. Even here in this paragraph, they have talked about the goods and services taxes which are paid by the registered person in a particular financial year. And here they have talked about one more thing, that is if he does not avail or he didn't avail the facility of input tax credit. So in that particular facility purpose, they have given some sort of guidelines, some sort of provisions. And what is that provision? Let me tell you. This is a person who is a registered person, but he has not availed input tax credit facility within a specified period. And this is what the amount of taxes, amount of that integrated tax account is expired, or after the expiry of that, what will happen that they have given here? If it is expired, then, or if it is expired of the due date, whatever due date is there, if he has not followed or she has not followed, or that particular registered person has not followed the due date, in that case, he has not furnished any annual return for that particular financial year, then what sort of provision is made that they have given in this particular paragraph? In respect of import of goods or services or both by an registered person or by a registered person paying tax under Section 10 of the Central GST Goods and Services Tax Act. So here the same condition which we have seen in the first paragraph is also applicable. And they have talked about now the import of goods and services. Import of goods and services means we buy those goods and services from foreign country. So if it is done for the import, again, in respect of import, again, we can say like this. So see, in respect, these are the different conditions. So here also, this is a new condition where they have been talked about import of goods and services or both by a unregistered person. In second case, that was a registered person, if you, I think, heard it properly. So that was registered person. But here they have been talked about import of goods and services done by the unregistered person or a registered person, both. Person paying tax under 10. If it is import made by a registered person or unregistered person under Section 10 of CGST Act, in that case, this particular integrated tax which is paid to central government is applicable. Then moving to the next condition, and what is that condition? Just look at this. In respect of import of goods or services or both, where the registered person is not liable for input tax credit. This one is the condition. What is the condition? That person who is doing the business of import is not liable for input tax credit. How? He is a registered person but not liable for input tax credit. So conditions they have given. The next condition is what? In respect of import of goods or services or both made in a financial year by a registered person where he does not avail the said credit within the specified period and thus remains in the integrated tax account after expiry of the due date for furnishing of annual return for such year in which supply was received. So these are the conditions. What is this second and last condition here? This person is a registered person. He deals with imports of goods and services or both, but he has not availed that particular facility during that particular span and thus the account or the amount of integrated tax account is expired and he has not furnished his annual return to the concerned authority. In that case, what will happen? So n number of conditions they have given. Once again, I repeat the condition. Look at the first condition. What was the first condition? In respect of interested supplier of goods and services by unregistered person, that was the first condition. In that condition, they have also talked about Section 10, and Section 10 talks about the taxes paid by the particular registered person under CGST Act 2017. Then the next condition is in respect of interstate supply of goods or services or both, where registered person is not eligible for input tax credit. So in second condition, they have been talked about the person who is a registered person and was dealing with interstate supply of goods and services, but he was not eligible for input tax credit. We are talking about the provisions which are made for this one, out of the integrated tax paid to the central government. When the integrated tax which is paid to central government is applicable, and for that these provisions are made. Then third condition, we have seen that in respect of interstate supply of goods or services or both in a financial year to a registered person where he does not avail of input tax credit within the specified period and thus remains in the integrated tax account after expiry of the due date for furnishing of annual return. That was the condition. Then a fourth condition we have seen, which was there for import of goods or services by an unregistered person or a registered person under Section 10. That also we have seen. Then we have seen the next condition, that was regarding the person who is paying taxes under Section 10 of CGST Act and dealing the business of import of goods and services or both, and that person is unregistered. The next one is what that was again, it was related to import of goods or services or both, and he is a registered person but not liable for input tax credit. Then again, we have seen the same thing or similar sort of things which was related to point number 3 or point number 4. Here we have seen the person is dealing with, or the registered person is dealing with, import of goods or services or both in a financial year, but he does not avail the said credit within a specified period. So these are the things which we guys have seen, or these are the provisions regarding out of the integrated tax paid to the central government. So here we can say in these cases only, or in these conditions only, that particular tax or integrated tax will be paid to the central government. Then look at the second point, the balance account of integrated tax remaining in the integrated tax account in respect of the supply for which an apportionment to the central government has been done under subsection. Just a minute. Hello. Hello, Delhi. You want to get admission? Well, it is in the state. I ask something like some admissions. Okay, so here in case of second clause, which is given as a provision for integrated tax paid to central government, second provision says that if the amount is in balance in integrated tax account, then what will happen? So balance amount of integrated tax remaining in the integrated tax account in respect of supply of which an apportionment of central government has been made, has been done under subsection 1, shall be apportioned to. So as we are talking about section 17, which is there for apportionment of integrated goods and services tax and settlement of funds. So here they have been talked about apportionment of taxes, which is done for the central government, which is done for the central government of India. See, as we collect IGST, now there is an apportionment. So how that apportionment is done, that they have given in clause number 2. So how it can be done, and for this particular purpose there are some subsections. So look at the things that they have made for the purpose of apportionment. So look at this, what they have said is shall be apportioned to central government like this, or state government like this. As I told you, the amount of this IGST or amount of every indirect tax is always apportioned between state government and central government. जे काही आपला इनडायरेक्ट टॅक्स असतो तो स्टेट गव्हर्नमेंट आणि सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंट मध्ये नेहमी अपोर्शन किंवा डिस्ट्रीब्यूट केला जातो. बट देर इज सर्टन यु नो देर आर सर्टन कंडिशन टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट इट. सो जस्ट गो थ्रू दिस. स्टेट वेअर सच सप्लाय टेक्स प्लस शाल बी अपोर्शन. सी इन दिस पर्टिक्युलर मॅनर स्टेट वेअर सच सप्लाय टेक्स प्लस अशा राज्यामध्ये जिथे सप्लाय करण्यात आला होता, ज्या राज्यामध्ये ह्याचा सप्लाय करण्यात आला होता त्या राज्याला एक अमाऊंट दिली जाईल. अँड दिस इज व्हॉट दे हॅव गिव्हन द यु नो पॅटर्न ऑफ अपॉर्शनमेंट ऑफ आयजीएसटी टू स्टेट गव्हर्नमेंट एज वेल एज सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंट. सो इन विच स्टेट दॅट सप्लाय वॉज टेकन प्लेस, द सप्लाय टूक प्लेस फॉर दॅट पर्टिक्युलर स्टेट ऑल्सो द अमाऊंट ऑफ आयजीएसटी इज गिव्हन. देन सेकंड वन इज सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंट वेअर central government where such supply takes place in a union territory. For example, as I was talking about the apportionment of integrated goods and services tax. Okay, sorry. So as I was discussing about the apportionment, first of all, we guys have seen the apportionment to the state government where the supply was actually taken place. Now the second part, after giving such amount to the such particular state, then we are going to talk about the share of central government. And the share of central government is what? Central government where the supply takes place in a union territory. So see, as we distribute the amount in state and central, so it is also given to the central. As well as it is also given to the union territory where the supply is actually taken or place which is actually taken place. So that is also important. So this is for the distribution of or apportionment of taxes or apportionment of amount of integrated taxes between the state as well as the central government. Then provided that where the place of such supply made by any taxable person cannot be determined separately, the said balance amount shall be apportioned to each of the states. So look at this sentence, as this sentence is, you know, important to understand what they have said. Provided that where the place of such supply made by a taxable person, where the place of such supply made by a taxable person cannot be determined. In case of that, for example, if any registered person has made a supply and he is a taxable person, but the place is difficult to find out. If it is difficult to find out the place where the supply is actually made by a registered person, so in that case, the said amount or the said balance amount shall be apportioned to each of the states. So this is what they have said. In that particular state, the amount of that particular tax will be apportioned or shall be apportioned to each states, those who are involved in that supply. Remember, then central government in relation to union territories in proportion to the supplies made by such taxable person to each of such states or union territories, as the case may be in a financial year. When it comes to central government or the role of central government with union territories, it is done proportionately. It is done in proportion to the total supplies made by such taxable person. So we are going to see the proportion made by that particular or that respective taxable person to each of the such states or union territories. If two or more states are involved in that particular transaction, so proportionately the amount of taxes, which is called as integrated goods and services taxes, will be apportioned between each states. For example, there is one state or one union territory, so amount will be given to that particular state as well as that particular union territory. So this way it will be done, and this is what it is called as apportionment. Then this one is the sort of explanation that you can read this, and after that we are going to see the point number 3. provisions of subsection 1 and subsection 2 relating to apportionment of integrated tax shall, okay, these are the shall, mutits and mutandis, these are the legal terms, apply to the apportionment of interest, penalty and compounding amount realized in connection with tax or apportionment. So these are the two terms. I will tell you the meaning of these two terms separately. Just we are keeping aside for a while only. I will tell you what are they. I think you guys have also gone through this. So just listen here what they have said. The provisions of subsection 1 and subsection 2 relating to apportionment of integrated tax. So see, under section 17, there are two subsections, subsection 1 and subsection 2. And these two subsections are relating to integrated tax. And here they have talked about apply to the apportionment. They have talked about the procedure of apportionment of interest, penalty and compounding amount realized in connection with tax so apportioned. So here, once the amount of tax is apportioned, and if it is penalty, interest or compounding amount is applicable for that apportioned tax, apportioned amount. So for that, this particular provision is made under section 17, subsection 1 and 2. Section 17 and madhya subsection 1 and 2 madhe kaay nemka sangitle, jar amount apportioned keli asel आणि त्याच्यावरती जर इंटरेस्ट पेनाल्टी किंवा कंपाउंडिंग अमाउंट अप्लिकेबल होत असेल तर ती कशा प्रकारे अपॉर्शन केली जाईल अँड दिस इज व्हॉट दिस पर्टिक्युलर सबसेक्शन 1 अँड सबसेक्शन 2 ऑफ सेक्शन 17 दे हॅव गिवन देन इट कम्स टू द नेक्स्ट वन दॅट इज क्लॉज नंबर 4 वेअर अन अमाउंट हॅज बीन अपॉर्शन टू द सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंट ऑर स्टेट गव्हर्नमेंट अंडर सेक्शन सबसेक्शन 1 ऑर सबसेक्शन 2 ऑर सबसेक्शन 3 The amount collected in integrated tax shall be stand reduced by an amount equal to the amount so apportioned, and central government shall transfer to the central tax account or union territory tax account an amount equal to the respective amounts apportioned to the central government and shall transfer to the state tax account of the respective states an amount equal to the amount apportioned to that state in such manner and within such time as may be prescribed. It's a paragraph, not a sentence. It's a paragraph and not a sentence. So we are going to break this paragraph into the sentences so that only we can understand. Otherwise, it is very difficult to understand. So it's my duty to break it. So I'm going to break it according to your convenience. Just look at this. Where an amount has been apportioned to central government or state government. See, ज्यावेळेस जी काय टॅक्सची अमाऊंट आहे ते सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंट आणि स्टेट गव्हर्नमेंट मध्ये अपॉर्शन केली जाते अंडर सेक्शन व्हॉट केली जाते कोणत्या सेक्शनचा आधार घेऊन सेक्शन 1 अँड सेक्शन 2 चा किंवा सेक्शन 3 चा आधार घेऊन सबसेक्शनचा सबसेक्शन 1 सबसेक्शन 2 सबसेक्शन 3 चा आधार घेऊन ज्यावेळेस ते अमाऊंट डिस्ट्रीब्यूट सॉरी apportion keli jate tyanantar the amount collected as integrated tax shall stand reduced je kai amount apan integrated tax manun collect kelele ahe ti amount reduce keli jail amount kami keli jail kontya amount parent by an amount equal to the amount so apportioned tya amount parent equal keli jail je amount apan ata apportion keleli ahe kunala apportion keleli ahe we have apportioned that amount to state and central government amount apportioned and equal to the amount apportioned and the central government shall transfer to the central tax account so whatever amount we have apportioned to the central government that amount central government will transfer to the central tax account जे काही आपण अमाऊंट स्टेट आणि सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंट मध्ये अपॉर्शन करतो किंवा वाटून देतो त्यानंतर जे काही सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंटची अमाऊंट असते ती अमाऊंट सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंट सेंट्रल टॅक्स अकाउंटला किंवा युनियन टेरिटरी अकाउंटला ट्रान्सफर करतं त्यानंतर an amount equal to the respective amounts apportioned to the central government shall transfer to the state tax account. Tarantar, whatever amount we transfer, we apportion to the central government as their share. Similar or same amount central government will transfer to the state accounts as the state government share. As we know that there is a right for the central government to decide the share of indirect taxes according to the status of that particular state, they get the amount. And here आपण बऱ्याचवेळा ऐकतो की वित्त मंत्री म्हणत असतात जीएसटीचा आमचा शेअर मिळाला नाही, जीएसटीचा शेअर मिळाला नाही म्हणून आमच्याकडे फंड नाही, लाईक दॅट. आय थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स विच वर हॅपन्ड इन कोविड पिरियड, our finance minister was asking for GST share and he was talking about there is no money in government treasury or like that. So this way they get the share, and the amount of share is given on the basis of development made by this that particular state. Those who are those which are developed states, they get lesser amount than the undeveloped states, because the central government will give amount to undeveloped states to develop themselves, but it is not happening. In India, I think there are 2-3 states which are very developed, like, you know, and those are Maharashtra, Gujarat, Punjab, UP is also not developed. So these are the developed states. They get lesser amount of share from the state or central government as their GST contribution. But mostly the contribution is given more to states like Bihar, then, Odisha, then West Bengal, Uttar Pradesh, MP, they get more share because they are a little bit undeveloped, but they get share. And whatever amount which will be apportioned to the central government, that will be transferred to the state account as their share. Then of the respective states, an amount equal to the amount apportioned to that state in such manner and within such time may be prescribed. So when that amount should be transferred and how much amount should be transferred, whether it is equal to the amount of central government, whether it is or equal to the amount of state government, that will be decided, and that is may be prescribed by the central government time to time. So this is for clause number 4. Moving to the clause number 5, and here we are going to talk about another provision which is made under section 17 of IGST Act. Any integrated tax apportioned to the state, apportion to a state, or as the case may be, to the central government on account of union territory, if subsequently found to be refundable to any person and refunded to such person, shall be reduced from the amount to be apportioned under section to such state or central government on account of such union territory in such manner and within such time as may be prescribed. So look at this. This one is a little bit new for you all. Here what they are talking about, if after the apportionment, if some amount is refunded to a registered person or for that particular person, in that case whatever amount is refunded to that particular person will be reduced from the share of the state government. So in that case, this particular or for this particular thing, this particular provision is made. त्याच्यामध्ये काय अपॉर्शनमेंट झालंय, अपॉर्शनमेंट झाल्यानंतर असे काही केस समोर आले की एखाद्या स्टेटमध्ये किंवा एखाद्या युनियन टेरिटरीमध्ये एखाद्या रजिस्टर्ड पर्सनला अमाऊंट रिफंड करणं गरजेचं होतं, पण रिफंड केली गेली नव्हती. यावेळेस ही अमाऊंट रिफंड करणं गरजेचं होतं, तरी सुद्धा केली नाही, म्हणजे त्याचे आपण अमाऊंट रिफंड करणं गरजेचं आहे, त्याला ते अमाऊंट रिफंड केली जाईल. मात्र ज्यावेळेस ती अमाऊंट रिफंड केली जाईल, त्यावेळेस द अमाऊंट विच वॉज विच इज रिफंडेड टू अ रिच पर्सन विल बी रिड्यूस्ड फ्रॉम द शेअर्स ऑफ स्टेट गव्हर्नमेंट एज वेल एज युनियन टेरिटरी. जी काही अमाऊंट आपण रिफंड करणार आहोत, ती अमाऊंट स्टेट गव्हर्नमेंट असेल, सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंट असेल, युनियन टेरिटरी शेअर असेल, या तिघांच्या शेअर्स मधून ती अमाऊंट ऑटोमॅटिकली एक प्रिस्क्राइब फॉर्मॅट मध्ये कमी केली जाईल. अँड दिस इज व्हॉट दिस पर्टिक्युलर प्रोव्हिजन नंबर 5 इज मेड. Moving on to the next one, that is 5.3, and here we are talking about transfer of input tax credit according to section 17 of IGST Act. So this particular section 17, sorry, section 18, extremely sorry, section 18 is there for transfer of input tax credit. As we know, we have understood the concept of input tax credit in a thorough manner in past lectures before, I think, before starting this new session, that is from June. So here we are talking about how that ITC can be transferred. What are the provisions which are there for transfer of input tax credit according to section 18? Those provisions we are going to see in this particular lecture. Just look at this. Section 18 of IGST Act 2017 explains transfer of input tax credit as below. In this regard, the amendments, if any, will also be updated here soon. There is no amendment as such so far in this particular transfer of input tax credit. The extract of section 18 of IGST Act 2017 is quoted below. So whatever points regarding this transfer of input tax credit according to section 18 are given below. We are going to see all those points one by one. So points are given for this one. What is that? On utilization of credit of integrated tax availed under this act for payment of. Just understand this, what they have said here. On utilization of credit of integrated tax availed under this act, payment of. See, amount of credit is utilized, and for what credit is given? Credit is given for integrated tax, and that is availed. If you are availing a facility of input tax credit, and if you are utilizing this, then certain provisions are made for the payment purpose. What are that? They have given here. Let me see how many, I think three provisions they have specifically made for the utilization of credit of integrated tax availed under this act for payment of. So just look at the first one, what they have said here. If you look at the first one, you may understand something. Central tax in accordance with provisions of subsection 5 of section 49 of Central Goods and Services Tax Act, the amount collected as integrated tax shall stand reduced by an amount equal to credit so utilized, and the central government shall transfer an amount equal to the amount so reduced from the integrated tax account to the central tax account in such manner and within such time as may be prescribed. So this particular provision is talking about if the amount of tax is reduced by a number of reasons. So if it is reduced, then central government will also transfer the amount equal to the reduced amount to the central tax account in a given manner, in a given prescribed format. So once again, I talk about this one. So what they have said here, just listen and try to understand, because question may be framed on such kind of, you know, subsections and sections. So just look at this. Central tax in accordance with provisions of subsection 5 of section 49 of Central Goods and Services Tax Act. This is only a clause. This was only a provision. So here what we are going to understand, central tax in accordance with provision of subsection 5 of section 49 of Central Goods and Services Tax Act. So they have been talked about the act, that is CGST Act 2017. Section is 49, subsection is 5, and this particular subsection deals with central tax. Okay, then here now the important point will start. What is that important point? Just look at this. The amount collected as, this is very important, huh? The amount collected as integrated tax shall stand reduced by an amount equal to the credit. Just wait. Hello. Waiting the form barla taka tumhi? Waiting the form barla taka? Aap kiti marks hai tumhara? Direct admission student given taka. Oh, इतने सगड़ा कर देते हैं मालूम prospectus download कर सगड़ा मालूम इतने रूम बसते नहीं था Okay, so I was talking about this and this particular provision, which is there according to section 49, subsection 5, and this provision talks about if it is the amount of collected integrated tax shall stand reduced. If it is reduced, जो काही आपण integrated tax collect केलाय तो समजा कमी झाला, तो जर कमी झाला असेल तर त्यावेळेस सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंटला तेवढ्याच अमाउंट, तेवढीच अमाउंट त्या सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंट टॅक्स अकाउंट म्हणजे सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंट टॅक्स अकाउंटला ट्रान्सफर करावी लागते आणि ठरवून दिलेल्या वेळेमध्ये आणि ठरवून दिलेल्या प्रिस्क्राइब फॉर्मॅटमध्ये. एकच मिनिट, फोन येतो. ओके, गेला. सो दिस इज क्लॉज वन. देन वी आर गोइंग टू सी द सेकंड क्लॉज. वी आर गोइंग टू सी ऑल दिस क्लॉज टुडे अँड देन वी विल वाइंड अप. युनियन टेरिटरी टॅक्स in accordance with provisions of section 9 of union territories goods and services tax act. Apan suruvatila central tax bagitla, ata we are going to see union territory tax. Teen prakarche taxes ahet gst madhe, igst, sgst. Igst tar ahes, cgst ahe, utgst zala ha ani ha sgst. Now we are talking about utgst, union territory tax in accordance with provisions of section 9 of the Union Territory Goods and Services Tax Act. This is just a part of provision according to section 9. The amount collected as integrated tax shall stand reduced by an amount equal to the credit so utilized, and the central government shall transfer an equal amount to the amount so reduced from the integrated tax account to the Union Territory tax account in such manner and within such time as may be prescribed. Very simple. Similar sort of things are there, only the word central tax is replaced, otherwise the entire process is same. फक्त इथं सेंट्रल टॅक्स आणि युनियन टेरिटरी टॅक्स आले, तेवढाच फक्त वर्ड बदललाय. त्यानंतर इथं जे सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंट ट्रान्सफर करत होतं अमाऊंट, ते सुद्धा सेम आहे, मात्र जी काय अमाऊंट ट्रान्सफर केली होतो दॅट विल बी ट्रान्सफर टू द युनियन टेरिटरी अकाउंट. दिस वन इज ऑल्सो चेंज, दिस वन इज ऑल्सो रिप्लेस्ड. हिअर इट वॉज सेंट्रल टॅक्स अकाउंट, नाव हिअर इट इज युनियन टेरिटरी टॅक्स अकाउंट. This is the only change, otherwise the entire format is same. Then moving to the last one, that is state tax in accordance with the provisions of the respective state goods and service tax act. So if it is reduced, what is the provision? Just look at this. The amount collected as integrated tax shall stand reduced by an amount equal to the credit so utilized, and shall be apportioned to the appropriate state government, and the central government shall transfer this amount so apportioned to the account of appropriate state government in such a manner and within such time as may be prescribed. So similar sort of things are there, again the word state tax is replaced, otherwise provision is same. And if the amount of integrated tax is reduced, then an equal amount to that will be utilized, will be apportioned to the state government by the central government, and central government will transfer the amount to the state government's account equal to the amount which was reduced in a prescribed manner, in a prescribed form. So this is what the provisions which are there for the purpose of transfer of input tax credit, which are given according to section 18 of IGST Act. So there are three different provisions. First was for central tax. Second was there for union territory tax, and third one was there for state tax. So three provisions we have seen, and here we take a break. But tomorrow we are going to talk about this 5.4 according to section 19, and here we are talking about if tax wrongfully collected and paid to central government or state government, if they have collected IGST wrongfully, and if it is paid to central government or state government, in that case what will happen, what are the provisions regarding that, those we are discussing in tomorrow's lecture. For today only this much. We are going to wind up, and if you have any question or doubts as such, you can put your questions put forward. So this is for today's session. Yes, I request you all again to go through the notes at home, read or start your study. I hope you guys have started your studies. If not, then we'll be in trouble. So do not do like this. Do your studies. काय आहेत का प्रश्न कोणाचे? प्रश्न आहेत का? नाहीत का? हॅलो, बोलते का कोण? उज्ज्वला?
येस सर.
प्रश्न आहेत?
नो सर, फक्त अकाउंट जरा विचारायचं होतं की ते कधी पर्यंत मिळेल मला. म्हणजे
आता सरांनी टाकलंय बघा, अमोल पाटील सरांनी आताच मी बघतोय 5 बजे फाईल टाकली त्यांनी बघा. आपल्या ग्रुपला आहे, आपल्या ग्रुपला.
हो ठीक आहे, चालेल. थँक्यू.
सांगा नाही तर मी त्यांना म्हणजे थोडस सांगून करून घेते ते काजीनगर करून.
ओके, थँक्यू सर.
ओके ओके, बाय बाय, सी यू टुमारो, बाय बाय. Let me stop the recording.